Now, as a programmer, you have a certain expectation as you add more processes to the system. Your expectation is natural if you think that if you add more processors, your performance should go up. So this is the expectation. This is what is called scalability, that the performance of a parallel machine is going to scale up as you increase the number of processors. Reasonable to expect that. However, I mentioned just now that there is overhead associated with increasing the number of processors in terms of maintaining cache coherence when you have sharing that is happening for shared data. And so therefore, the pro in adding more processors is the fact that you can exploit parallelism. That's the reason why you're able to get this expectation of increased performance with processors. But unfortunately, as you increase the number of processors, there is increased overhead. And this increased overhead also grows. As you increase the number of processors, more overhead is going to be incurred by the system. If you have an 8 processor SMP, the overhead for cache coherence is less than if you have a 16 processor SMP or a 32 processor or a 64 processor. So the overhead is going to grow. As a result, you can see that you have the pro of exploiting parallelism, but you have the con of increased overhead, and you end up with an actual performance that's somewhere in the middle between your expectation and the overhead. So in some sense, there's a difference between what your expectation is and what the overhead you're paying, and that becomes your actual delivered performance of a parallel machine. And this is very important to remember, that your delivered performance may not necessarily be linear in the number of processors that you add to the system. So what should we do to get good performance? Don't share memory across threads as much as possible if you want good performance from the parallel machine. A quote that is attributed to a famous computer scientist, Chuck Thacker, comes to mind. Shared memory machines scale well when you don't share memory. Of course, as operating system designers, we have no control over what the application programmer does. All we can do is to ensure that the use of shared data structures is kept to a minimum in the implementation of the operating system code itself. You will see how relevant Chuck Thacker's quote is as we visit operating system synchronization, communication, and scheduling algorithms, and more generally, the structure of the operating system itself in this lesson. See if you can remind yourself of this quote and how often it permeates through our discussion as we go through this lesson.